Most ultrasound machines will calculate fractional shortening automatically as soon as you perform a measurement of the left ventricular internal diameter in diastole and then systole. However, fractional shortening can be very misleading. It's affected by loading conditions, heart rate, and because it measures radial function, when longitudinal function begins to fail, we often see a temporary increase in radial function to compensate, so in that way it could actually mask systolic dysfunction. Let's take a look at this patient. What can we see? Well, there are thickened mitral valve leaflets. The anterior or septal leaflet is particularly thickened, and there seems to be a slight loss of coaptation at the tips. The left atrium is severely dilated. You can see that just by comparing it with the right atrium across the septum. And the left ventricle looks very dilated as well. What do you think colour Doppler will show? Unsurprisingly, severe mitral regurgitation. Taking our measurements the traditional way, through the short axis with M mode, my scanner is automatically giving me a fractional shortening of 42%. Fractional shortening is simply the size change of the left ventricle between diastole and systole along a single linear plane. Now, fractional shortening over 25% is considered normal, but how likely is it that this patient, who has severe long-standing mitral valve disease and a dilated left ventricle, actually has normal left ventricular systolic function? This left ventricle is having to work extra hard to deal with this exceptionally large volume of blood. If you were to send this dog for mitral valve repair and perform an echocardiogram the next day or even a few days later, you would visually see that this left ventricle is impaired. The severe mitral regurgitation is masking the underlying systolic dysfunction. There are all sorts of fancy ways to demonstrate this, such as strain, tissue Doppler imaging, but the main takeaway here is that in patients with severe valvular regurgitation, we should always be extra cautious when assessing systolic function. And we certainly shouldn't look to something as flawed as fractional shortening to give us an answer. If you're stuck with anything in echocardiography, would like to be part of a community where you can share your scans with others for a second opinion, or if you've had a particularly difficult case that you'd like to talk through with somebody, we would love to work with you. There's more information in the description below.